Welcome to World Action and Reaction News. Today we discuss Lca Tejas is Sami stealth jet, but question is how much? The RCS of Tejas has been brought down significantly by modifying shape aspects within the limitations set by aerodynamics. Tejas got one of the best RCS value in the entire fourth generation fighters. Publicly available figure is 0.5 meter square. Tejas is a light aircraft. It is the smallest. It is difficult to have a view of it even in a WVR dogfight, making it even more lethal and deadly. The smooth upper wing body blending of Tejas gives it enough stealth to avoid early detection. This kind of upper body blending is only being seen in later generation fighters from Sukhoi, Rafale, Eurofighter Typhoon, F-22, PAKFA, and J-20. This high wing body blending is the hallmark of even the 5th gen fighters, reducing the corner reflections from the awacs radars searching from above, resulting in lower RCS with missiles and external source hidden under the wing. Tejas design incorporates a high wing body fuselage blending implemented from behind, resulting in smooth bouncing off of searching radar waves from behind, whether they are X-band or L-band or AESA or mechanical, it does not matter. If Tejas flies low, hiding its stores, no airborne radar will detect it from beyond 120 km due to 0.3 sq meter RCS, from above, clarification needed. High wing body fuselage blending is implemented from behind, resulting in smooth bouncing off radar waves. Another stealth feature of Tejas is its Y intake, also called bifurcated intake. Engine fan blades are one of the prominent sources of increasing radar cross-section. This Y intake buried the jet engine inside the fuselage, so no engine parts are visible and thus increases the stealth characteristics. Canopy is another good radar reflector. Radar waves normally enter the cockpit reflex of objects and possibly return to the radar, and even the HMD of pilot itself contributes to RCS. To avoid this, Tejas canopy is coated with a thin film transparent conductor of indium tin oxide. The coating is thin enough that it has no adverse effect on pilot vision and can reflect the radar waves away from the radar antenna. Almost 90% of the surface of Tejas is made by carbon composites. These composites are much less reflective than metals. This helps in reduction of the RCS of Tejas. The Tejas employs CFC materials for up to 45% of its airframe, including in the fuselage, doors and skins, wings, skin, spars and ribs, elevons, tail fin, rudder, air brakes and landing gear doors. Composites are used to make an aircraft both lighter and stronger at the same time compared to an all-metal design, and the LCA's percentage employment of CFCs is one of the highest among contemporary aircraft of its class. Some reports saying India also developing carbon nanotube reinforced carbon composites for future use. This will lead to further reduction in RCS. CFC have other advantages. They don't deteriorate with age nor corrode due weather elements. CFC also gives Tejas better operational empty weight, giving Tejas better thrust to weight ratio when compared with other aircrafts with similar engines. CFC does have their own disadvantages. They are expensive to make. India already got patent in RAM coatings. The use of RAM coatings further decreases its RCS dramatically. Better coatings are under researching. Tejas is a single-engine aircraft, so it is inherently less susceptible to IRSTs compared to twin-engine aircrafts. ADA pointed out that they already reduced the IR signature of Tejas, making it more survivable against heat-seeking missiles.
Thanks for watching. I hope you like this news. Please share your views in comment box. Please like and share this video. Press subscribe button and bell for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News. Warn.